Hey guys, this is Dave again. Just wanted to do another installment of the DIY CNC series. And I think we're getting to a point where we can kind of, this is by no means the final episode, not even close, but what I want to walk through is if you're going to use a stepper system, how does that all work together? What is the chain that actually makes the motor do what you're telling it to? So that's what I'm going to talk about today, and I just want to explain and show everybody how simple it is. What you're looking at are a few various pieces that are needed to actually accomplish the movement. You've seen all the ball screws, you've seen all the linears, you've seen all the THK linear actuators and everything, but just the blood and guts of, okay, I've got a computer. The computer has to tell that motor how far to move, what direction to go in. How does that take place? So what I want to do is explain that right now. So you're actually looking at, this is two systems that you're looking at right now. And let me talk about the first one, which is the all-in-one system. This is a Mechatronics three-axis board, very similar to what I used on my four-axis mini CNC machine. I've since sold that machine, but it actually had this exact same board, except it had an additional, you see these heat sinks, those are representative of each stepper controller, and it had an additional one on there for a total of four. This is just a three-axis controller, again from Mechatronics. I bought this off eBay as a set, actually. It came with three steppers, excuse me, the three-axis controller board that you see here, a 24-volt power supply, and then a relay that I could use to toggle my spindle off and on. So this is actually what tells the motors what to do, and it gets its commands from the parallel port on your computer. Typically with Mach, you can't use a laptop to run it because of the power saver features of the parallel port. So what I'm talking about is using a standard PC that has a printer port on it. And it just connects with this DB25 connector here. And that, by the way, that you set your ports and pins inside of Mach 3, that's what sends the instructions to this board. It turns it into the necessary code to tell the stepper motor what to do, or the pulse and direction and whatnot. So without getting into the bloody details of it. So what it does is it takes the 25 pins that come off the printer port, and you assign those pins certain responsibilities based on what you've got hooked up on here. So in the very simplest way that this would be is you would see this board sitting here. You would have a printer cable that comes in, connects right here. You would have a power connector that comes in, I believe, yes, right here. And then the rest of these are going to be signal. On this particular board, I've got some data inputs that I can use. I've got an error output. I've got three pins of ground that I can use, and I've got a disable input. On my first revision of my larger CNC machine, each axis had a cherry switch at the beginning of the travel and at the end of travel. And what that would do is it was normally high or normally connected. And if the axis hit that switch, it would break that connection. Those two switches were in series. And what it would basically do is it would drop out that controller. So one of these controllers would actually lose power. And that's how the machine protected itself. In the event that the travel exceeded normal bounds and it hit the switch, then it would say, I'm going to shut that axis down to prevent damage to the machine. And so that's how this particular one works. So once I've got the PC cable in, basically the stepper motors hook on these three headers here. I'll use this NEMA 34 as an example. Those four wires would just go into here. Each one of them is fuse protected. And that really is it. The responsibility from that point is to go into Mach and assign the ports and pins correctly to tell each motor what to do and what direction to go in. So that, I mean, this makes it very easy, and that's how I started. So I have moved on to a different setup, and it's got some more pieces, but I think it works a little bit better. And so what you're looking at here is a C10 board from, I believe I got this from CNC4PC, and this is the same board that I'm using on my current CNC machine. And what it does is it takes the parallel port connection, and what it gives me is a bunch of IOs. our inputs and outputs. So this board does require 5-volt power to do what it needs to do. So you just hook up a 5-volt power supply. I think I took one off of an old PC network switch or something like that. And so I've got different ports of input, different ports of output. And what this allows me to do is I can configure this in Mach 3 and say, okay, well, this by default is going to be port 1 if it's using the parallel port on your PC. And so then I'll say port 1 pin 2 is going to be the step pulse for the x-axis. And then I'll say port 3 is going to be the direction pulse for the x-axis. So that's going to assign these two, and I'm using this as an example, it's going to assign 2 and 3 as step and direction for one axis. So out of that step and direction, just taking three wires out of there, a common and the two signal wires, I've got step and direction on here. And so I'll run the step to the step input, and I'll run the direction to the direction input, and I'll have a ground in there. And then my motor will actually connect to this header here. So this system is basically taking that stuff apart, but it makes it more modular. This particular driver is a Kaling KL6050, and it can do 5 amps max. That little board over there can only do, I think, maybe 1.5 or 2. So this just makes it easy. I even have an enable and disable on here, so if I wanted to put hard stops like I had on my original machine, I could wire that into this first pin header here, and it would give me the same safety to stop that motion if I needed to stop it in a hurry. These have built-in heat sinks. They're made very nicely, pretty solid, and you just basically can mount them to a back plane, and then you can have all your stepper drivers just loaded up in there. And if you've seen the walk around in my larger machine, this is actually the driver for the fourth axis that I haven't made use of on my larger machine yet. So that is really the quick and dirty. Parallel port cable connects into here. You take your step and direction signals off of your C10 board and then run them into the corresponding connectors on your driver. And this could be any maker driver. You could actually do this with servos, because a lot of those servo drivers that are out there can take a step and direction pulse as well. So you could drive it the exact same way. So this is the quick and dirty. If you have any questions, please ask. I'm not trying to oversimplify it. It is pretty straightforward once you get into it. And one thing that you could possibly run into on this board, like I have, is I ran out of inputs. So you can use one of these inputs as an e-stop. So you hit that e-stop that tells Mach to stop everything you're doing. And that's when I had to go in and add, you can either add a second C10 board, or you can add something like a Pokey's USB input device. But these are really good, very robust. I've never blown one up yet, which is probably a testament to the design. But again, thanks for watching. We're going to continue this path and see where it leads us, and we'll talk to you next time.